Assalamu alaikum, dear students. You know, we are discussing this partial integration or integration by the partial fractions. Yesterday we discussed how to integrate the proper fraction when the denominator has distinctive factors or when the denominator has when the factors of denominator are repeats. Now today we shall discuss, you know, the case when denominator of this proper fraction, that is q of x, cannot be factorized. Like if we consider an example x square plus x plus 2 1, here it is quadratic. You know, by quadratic method it cannot be factorized. This means that it has no roots in R, which implies that this q of x cannot be factorized in R. Like if we factorize x square minus 1, it can be written as x minus 1 into x plus 1. So in this case we put p of x upon q of x, which is p of x upon x square plus x plus 1, where this is proper fraction. This means that degree of p of x here should be less than degree of this 2, that is degree of this q of x. Here when the factors does not repeat and it has 2, its degree is 2, this means that we have to put this term as ax plus b upon x square plus 1 plus x square plus x plus 1, because the number of constants involved or the number of constants used equals to the degree of q of x. Like if we consider an example which is question of this exercise 7.5, like 3x minus 1 upon x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3. This is proper and the factors are distinct. So this means that by case first we put 3x minus 1 upon x minus 1 x minus 2 x minus 3 equals to a upon x minus 1 plus b upon x minus 2 plus c upon x minus 3, because the degree of here q of x is 3. So this means that it has 3 factors, hence we have to use 3 constants. So multiplying by cross multiplication, we get 3x minus 1 equals to x minus 2 x minus 3 a plus x minus 1 into x minus 3 b plus x minus 1 into x minus 2 c. This is equation second. Now when we put x equals to 2 in equation second, so we simply get b equals to minus 5, because this is polynomial and it is defined for each and every, or in particular it is defined for x equals to 2. Similarly, by putting x equals to 1, we get a equals to 1, and by putting x equals to 3, we get c equals to 4. So here we determined these three constants, b equals to minus 5, a equals to 1, c equals to 4. So put these three values in equation first, we get 3x minus 1 upon x minus 1 into x minus 2 into x minus 3 equals to 1 upon x minus 1 minus 5 upon x minus 2, because b is here minus 5, plus 4 upon x minus 3. Then integrate this equation, we get integral of 3x minus 1 upon x minus 1 x minus 2 x minus 3 dx equals to integral of 1 upon x dx minus 5, because 5 is constant, it comes out from this integral is minus 5 integral 1 upon x minus 2 dx plus 4 integral of 1 upon x minus 3 dx. Now we know that the integration of 1 upon x is log x, and in particular its integration is log x minus 1. Similarly, minus log x minus 2 and plus log x minus 4 plus 4 log x minus 3 plus c. Now we can use here m raised power n rule. Here it is log, this 5 log x minus 2 can be written as log x minus 2 raised to power 5, and 4 log x minus 3 can be written as log x minus 3 raised to power 4. So using log m plus log n, which is log x minus 1 into x minus 3 raised to power 4, because 2 logs are positive, and then we have minus log x minus 2 raised to power 5, which is log m minus log n, which is log m by n. So after simplifying this and using these two, we get log mod of x minus 1 into x minus 3 raised to power 4 upon x minus 2 raised to power 5 plus c is the required indefinite integral when the factors when the this q of x has distinctive factors. Now consider this third case when we cannot factorize the proper fraction. Here q of x is x square plus 1 into x minus 1. It has one factor as x minus 1, and the remaining term in this is x square plus 1, so we cannot factorize this because x square plus 1 has no roots in R. This means that we have to put x upon x minus 1. For this we have to put a upon x minus 1, because for this factor we have to use one constant, and for this quadratic term, that is x square plus 1, we have to use bx plus c upon x square plus 1, because x square plus 1, its degree is 2, so we have to use two different constants. Dividing this by, we get x equals to, by cross multiplication, we get x equals to x square plus 1a plus x minus 1 into bx plus c. Name it equation second. So put x equals to 1, we get a equals to 1 by 2. Here we cannot again put, because we can put, but this expression becomes complicated. So in order to simplify this, we have to simply relate the coefficients. By relating the coefficients of x square, in LHS coefficient is 0, in RHS it is ax square minus a and bx into x, that is bx square. This means that coefficient of x square in LHS is 0, and in RHS its coefficient is a plus b, which is a plus b equals to 0, that is b equals to minus 1 by 2. Similarly, by comparing the constants, it is x here. By comparing the constants, we get 0 equals to, now here it is here in this equation second. Constant in LHS is 0, constants in RHS are 1 is a, second one is minus c, which implies that a equals to 1 by 2. Substitute in equation first and integrate, we get x upon integral of x upon x minus 1 into x square plus 1 dx equals to 1 by 2 integral 1 upon x minus 1 dx plus minus 1 by 2 x plus 1 by 2 upon x square plus 1, which is, now we break this denominator, that is minus 1 by 2 x upon x square plus 1 and plus 1 by 2 1 upon x square plus 1. Here integration of this is log x minus 1. Now if we put denominator, it is differentiation is 2x, so multiplying and dividing this integral by 2, so we get minus 1 by 4. It is integration is log x square plus 1, because the differentiation of this denominator became as the numerator. Similarly, 1 by x square plus 1, that is 1 by x square plus a square, is of the form of 1 by x square plus a square, so its integration is 1 upon a tan inverse x by a, which is plus 1 by 2 tan inverse x plus c. So this is the required indefinite integral of this given proper fraction whose denominator contains a term or a factor which we cannot further factorize. So inshallah, in tomorrow's video lecture, we will discuss, the case when this fraction is improper fraction. So thank you.